Good morning, everyone. Let's start with today's topic, that is geriatric rehabilitation. The contents will be definition, theories of aging, physiological changes in aging, demographic data of disability, models of disability, principles of geriatric rehabilitation, and value to give. Let's just look at the theories of aging, physiological changes, and demographic data for today. The other last 3 points we'll be dealing in the next class. Definition. According to Denham and Hammond, says that aging is the result of progressive accumulation of changes in the body. It is normal, but the changes compared to a youngster and the old person are different. As the age progresses, there are several changes occurring in the body relating to musculoskeletal structure, respiratory structure, neurological structure, and the rest all structures or systems within the body. This changes in the body, which occur with passing time and which causes the increase in the probability of disease, and eventually the person dies. Geriatric rehabilitation can be defined as medical treatment plus prevention, restoration plus accommodation and education. Coming to classification according to the age group. What is age defined universally? At what age old age begins cannot be defined universally. Accepted chronological age by world is usually 65 and above. Hence, subgrouping of the age is needed because we need to understand after 65 is known as old age. But what if the person is 65 to 75 and the 100 years person? How can we differentiate them? How old is he? Hence, subgrouping of age is definitely needed. It is subcategorized into 3 parts, that is young old, middle old, and oldest old. Young old lies between 65 to 74, middle old lies between 75 to 84, whereas oldest old lies between 85 and 85 above. Sorry. Coming to characteristics of aging. Aged person usually has decreased respiratory capacity of organ system. This is apparently only during periods of exertion or stress. If you tell a person, a youngster, to just climb the mountain Kailash, he can climb easily. I'm just giving an example. He can climb easily. But when you ask the old person to climb so, the scenario will be so stressful and will induce so much exertion on his system that he feel that there is a reduction in the oxygen. Hence, because of the changes anatomically as well as physiologically, there is definite decrease in reserve capacity of the organ system. Coming to the second point, decreased internal homeostatic control, that is blunting of the thermoregulatory system, decline in baroreceptor sensitivity, and etc. Third point, decreased ability to adapt in response to different environments. A vulnerability to hypothermia and hyperthermia with changing temperature is lost in the old age people. Also, orthostatic hypotension with change in position is a definite factor which we can see in old people. Suddenly, if you ask a patient or ask an old person to get up from the bed, suddenly he might lose his balance due to dizziness occurring due to orthostatic hypotension. Fourth point and the final point, characteristic of aging, decreased capacity to respond to stress, that is exertion, fever, anemia, etc. Anything. Now coming to theories of aging. Depending on genetic theory, the genetic classification, it is divided into 2 types. That is developmental, that is based on genetic, and environmental is non-genetic. In developmental, genetic makeup determines the factor directly affecting the age. How strong is his DNA? That is going to determine how old he can live his life. There are so many other factors as well, but this is the genetic theory of aging. So based only on his DNA, we can determine how much lifespan the person has, when he is going to die. Approximately, we can determine that. So genetic makeup determines factors directly affecting the aging. Second point, programmed and directed in the body. It is already programmed and it is directed by the body only. Aging is predetermined. I already told you by DNA we can predetermine the aging. Environmental factor. Environmental factor is not written in our DNA. It is not even written in our RNA. So it is all present outside, like our natural calamities, cyclones, COVID-19, which is occurring in recently. These are the random events that occur over time. COVID-19 is not going to persist further. We cannot judge till when the COVID-19 is going to stay in the world. So this is a random event which occurs over time. After some time, it might just vanish off. So many people have already died due to COVID-19 because of their low or weak immunity. People who are alive even after COVID positive have stronger immunity. So environmental factor is such that which occurs due to random event that occur over time can lead to aging. Aging caused by environmental damage. It can be neurological, it can be respiratory, it can be cardiovascular, it can be musculoskeletal, it can be anything else, any other system as well. Environmental is controlled extrinsically. We could have controlled any disease which is forming, which is causing harmful to our body, which is outside. For example, if you keep your hand on the hot pan continuously, you know the pan is hot. Still, you keep it for around 5 hours, you will land up burning your hand. So, environmental factor is your hot pan. You can control the not touching the hot pan. That is, environmental factor can be controlled extrinsically. Coming to age-related changes. First point, physical changes related to normal aging are not disease. When you tell a person who is aging, he has definite spinal changes. He also has definite musculoskeletal changes. These can be increase in the kyphosis because the bone loses its BMD, that is bone mineral density, due to which the allogy shifts forward and then there is increase in the kyphosis. These are all normal ones, 80 or 65 according to the classification. Let's talk about the classification. According to 65 plus is the age. He will start undergoing his spine into kyphotic stages slowly, gradually, progressively. But now these are not diseases. This has occurred due to his aging process, because there is shortening in the height, because there is decrease in bone mineral density, because there is compensatory action due to all such factors occurring. Hence, he has attained the kyphotic posture. But now, if this is seen in a 20 plus young adult, that time it is termed as a disease or a dysfunction. But when it is seen in 65 plus, it is not disease, it is just an aging process. People who live an active lifestyle lose less muscle mass and flexibility as they age. People who are sedentary, their muscles get early fatigued and they definitely lose the muscle mass, that is hypertrophy of the muscle, and also the flexibility as the age progresses. Muscle mass reduction is more commonly seen in people who were leading a sedentary lifestyle compared to the active lifestyle people in old age. So this is an important point. Hence, active lifestyle is very important to lead our daily life. Coming to the third very important point, multifaceted problems faced by elderly population due to complex chain of decompensation of body function. When you talk about aging, when our parents reach at a certain age, or when we have seen as a children that our grandparents are complaining of knee pain, back pain, loss of balance, cannot see, cannot hear. These are not different problems, or they are not psychologically ill. They have so many different problems. They are not the problems, actually speaking. They are just the normal aging process of each system present within the body. When you talk about aging process, it is not only the physical thing which is aging, that is your skin is aging and the person dies. No, it is not. It doesn't work like that. Every system, every cell in the body ages. Hence, we see there are so many changes even in your sensory as well as your motor performance in once the age is increasing. Hence, elderly people have multifaceted problems which they may face during daily living activities. This occurs due to decomposition of the body function. Coming to age-related changes. This diagram was taken from death by underlying or multiple cause expressed in rates per 1 lakh people as a function of age for the 2001 US population aged 85 and older. Source is from CDC, NCHS, National Vital Statistics System mortality data. So the diagram over here represents the maximum percent is occupied by the heart. The second one is occupied by the malignant neoplasm. Third one is occupied by the cerebrovascular disease. Fourth one is occupied by the Parkinsonism. Fifth one by Alzheimer's disease. And the sixth one by pneumonia. Seventh one by chronic lower respiratory disease. Eighth one is diabetic. Ninth one is certain infectious and parasitic diseases. Tenth one is atherosclerosis. And the one more bigger part is known as others. This others can be caused due to death due to unknown cause or anything else. Currently, the scenario is slightly different because of COVID-19. Maximum percentage of death in the current scenario is due to COVID-19. And second falls the rest. Coming to sensory changes, let's look at it one by one. When we are talking about sensory changes, you should always remember sensory systems, that is hearing, vision, touch and pain, and taste and smell. So how will an aged person have different sensory changes compared to a youngster? First thing, take this to be an old age person. He will stop seeing near, he cannot identify near and far objects. Second, he will also have blurred vision. Second one, hearing disability. He might develop or may not develop hearing disability. Eventually, if he develops also, it will be so little that it goes unnoticed. Third point will be smell. That is taste and smell. Person won't recognize what does this smell as. He will not understand the rice smells different and the curry smells different. So there will be disability in taste and smell as well. The last point, touch and pain. He might land up walking on thorn and he will not realize that something has pricked and it is painful and he has got bleeding issues. So that is disability of touch and perception, that is pain. Coming to changes in nervous system. So take this to be a person. This the pink structure is nothing but your brain, and the red network is the blood supply to the brain. The blue line in the center is a spinal column, and the yellow lines are nothing but your spinal nerves arising from the spinal column. That is your sacral and lumbar and cervical plexus. Now, as the age progresses, there is decrease in the brain weight, also along with the reduction of the blood supply to the brain. After that, due to this, then once the person wants to sleep, there is in one once the age is progressed, the sleep pattern is different and the sleep time is reduced. Hence, changes in sleep pattern in old age is very common and very frequent when compared to young adult. Also, when we talk about spinal column, we know that cervical plexus and lumbar plexus, which supply to the peripheral limbs, that is your upper and lower extremity, arise from the spinal cord. Hence, there is something called as sensory supply and motor supply by your peripheral nervous system, which arise from the spinal cord. These take up the signals from the periphery, send it to the brain via the spinal cord system. So it has some velocity to travel. As the age progresses, due to the thinning of the nerves, that is due to the reduction in the diameter of the nerve, there is reduction in the nerve conduction velocity as well. Also, when a person sees any danger, for example, in the picture, if he sees any crocodile, he doesn't understand what to do. He knows it is a danger. He remembers, sometimes he can remember that crocodile is danger. So, but due to weak or slower response and reaction time, he might just go slowly away from the crocodile, and by the time crocodile may come and snatch his leg up. So these are the changes in nervous system. Let's look at the changes in respiratory system. Consider this to be your old age and the trachea and the lungs. First sign in old age is the lungs become rigid. The lungs have lost its capacity to contract and during exhalation and in relax during inhalation. That is, the lungs have become very rigid and loss of elasticity is definite once the age has progressed. Second point, we all know that lungs consist of subspace which is of no use. That is all that is known as dead space. There is definite increase in the dead space quantity in the aged lung. Third point will be blunting of the cough. When you cough, there's some sound heard by the other people as well. But in when the old age cough, the sound decreases. There is blunting of cough reflex. This occurs due to decreased ciliary movement and decreased diameter of the trachea. Coming to musculoskeletal system of in musculoskeletal changes in aging. When we talk about height of a person, we definitely find that as the age progresses, the height decreases. This occurs due to decrease in the spinal height. A study proved that between ages 20 and 70, height decreases approximately by 2 inches due to this height decrease in spinal column. Second point will be maybe due to short stature, the person attains a slouched posture, not only due to short stature, due to fatigability of the extensors, which are the powerful muscle, undergo fatigability. Eventually, with the time in progression, he might attain the slouched posture. This slouching of posture is most prominently seen in the thoracic region. To compensate this posture, to walk or to sit and stand without losing his balance, he might land up in having slight knee and hip flexion just in order to maintain the COG within the base of support. Also, one important point is reduced bone mineral density, which is definite seen in was seen once the person progresses his age. So thank you. This was the first part of geriatric aging and its rehabilitation. Let's meet you all in the next part where we'll be discussing about principles of geriatric rehabilitation.